to rain for lunch.
Alright class, so Earth Day is coming up because we're learning about the environment. When we're signing a group project, we'll learn you will have to work together to come up with a way to save the Earth. Before anyone asks, I will be assigning the groups.
Other characters grown.
First off, Jill and Clara, I think you make a good group.
Standing up.
What?
These people are crazy. They offered me $20,000 for this thing? What is it?
Oh, nothing. Haha, just some name tag I got a while back from some summer camp I volunteered for.
So, it's just trash?
You mean very expensive trash. So you see, child, you're only as, how did you say it? Yes. You're only as fabulous to others as you think yourself to be. This name tag may be trash to you, but if you treat it as if it were gold, others will also think of it as gold and treat it as such. And always think good thoughts, especially about yourself.
Okay.
Exit fortune cookie. Jill holds the name tag up and stares at it, thinking about what the walking fortune cookie said, and the back too. Act 4. now the start of class is again, and the students file back into the classroom as the bell rings to start of class. Claire and Jill take their seats in the room as Mr. Teacher begins his class. Enter Mr. Teacher, Clara, and Jill.
Welcome back from lunch, everyone. I hope you all had a wonderful time and took some time to prepare for your project. Just in case you didn't, I figured it would be a good idea for all of you to take some time now and brainstorm what you would like to do for your project. So let's get into your groups and start brainstorming.
The class shuffles into their groups, and Clara and Jill awkwardly move next to each other and begin talking about their project.
So, what would you like to do for the project?
I don't know. To be honest, I don't get the point of this project.
What do you mean? We're thinking of ways to save the very world we live in. What are you having trouble understanding?
Yeah, like, I know we're trying to save the world and everything, but like, what's the point? Obviously, people are not as fabulous as me, aren't gonna care about the world, and there's a lot of people clearly not as fabulous as me. So why bother?
What do you mean, why bother? Just because no one else cares doesn't mean we shouldn't care too.
Mr. Teacher, having in listening to Jill's and Clara's conversations, steps in.
You're exactly right, Jill. Just because there isn't someone else out there doing the right thing, it doesn't mean that we should stop trying to do the right thing.
Yeah, but we won't make a difference. There's so many people out there, and we're just two people. We don't even have power. Like, the President of the United States has a lot of power, and so does Venerable Master, and we don't have it. We're just middle school.
Yeah, Mrs. Teacher, I think Clara is right. I know what we're doing is for a good purpose, but two people can only do so much.
Yes, and maybe two people just happen to be the two people we need to start something. Have you ever heard the expression, to stick up the camel's back?
What are you talking about, Mrs. Teacher?
It's a metaphor.
What's a metaphor?
It doesn't matter. My point is that one person can have a big impact on others. When we talk about the stick that broke the camel's back, we're saying that this camel carried a lot of sticks on his back already. But when we put one more stick on his back, the camel can no longer carry all the sticks and falls down. The same goes for saving the world. Just you guys or just this class may not see the impact of your projects. It doesn't mean that they're not important. Maybe your projects are the last stick on the camel's back and contribute to the pile of sticks that can save the world. And if you didn't do your project, the world wouldn't be saved.
Mr. Teacher, I still don't understand your point.
Think of it this way, Clara. Do you think my class is boring?
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Well, thanks, Laura.
No problem, Mr. Teacher.
More to the point, you're probably not the only one who thinks my class is boring. In fact, most of the class probably thinks my class is boring. And I wonder why I'm a teacher. No one here really wants to learn about saving the Earth, so why teach?
Oh no, I'm sure not everyone thinks global warming is boring.
Exactly, Clara. There's always a chance that one person in the class might find my lesson interesting and learn something really important from it. Who knows, maybe my class will inspire the person to grow up and save the world. That's why I teach, so that one person has the chance to learn about what might be interesting to them and make a difference in the world. The same goes for your project. Maybe, just maybe, your project is the project that inspires the two of you to make a difference or encourages someone else in the class or maybe the world to go out and make a difference to the planet.
Oh my Buddha! I might inspire someone to be as fabulous as me.
Yes, Clara.
Oh my gosh, that's so cool! Quick, Jill, let's go save the world!
Okay. Let's start researching some ideas.
And the duo began to work together and brainstorm ideas for their Earth Day project. And the back four. Act 5. It's Earth Day and the class is busy presenting their project. Clara and Jill are called to present their project. Enter Clara, Jill, Mr. Teacher, and the rest of the class.
cell phones in the trash.
Shut it.
And the chemicals in the battery can leak out and damage the environment. That's why you should recycle your electronics.
We only have one fabulous earth and we should do our best to protect it. No matter how small that effort is, it always makes a difference.
And with multiple small efforts, we can make a greater impact on the world. Well done, both of you.
Enter Force for Cookie.
And kids, remember you can always make a difference, no matter who you are or where you are.
It's you!
Oh, I've seen you met my teacher, Mr. Fedora.
Not Walking Fortune Cookie?
Nope.
Oops.
Remember when I told you about making a difference to one student? Mr. Fedora, you're talking that.
Mr. Teacher then explains that Mr. Fedora was a teacher once, and while most of the students didn't care, he made a difference to one student, and that was him. That's why we do good things for others, because we never know how that one good deed may change an entire person's life. So no matter how small an act may be, always know that you've changed the life of someone out there. The small act of kindness made a difference to them. The end.
Writer Andy and our editor.